Hello, welcome to BioGrades TV. If you are new here, please subscribe and turn on the notification so you don't miss our next video. Crude oil in Nigeria, discovery and production. The discovery of crude oil in Nigeria has been seen as a blessing and a curse depending on who you ask. This is because before oil in the country, her economy was said to be better than it is today in the 21st century. In this video, we want to take a look at how crude oil was discovered in Nigeria. Crude oil is a form of liquid petroleum that is extracted from rock formations and used for fuel and other purposes. Once it is extracted, it undergoes distillation, which breaks the liquid down into various products depending on the composition of the liquid. The largest part of crude oil is used for diesel, gasoline, jet fuel, and heating oils. Crude oil is one of Nigeria's most profitable natural resources. Exploration in Nigeria. The Nigerian Bitumen Corporation had been looking for oil since 1907 until World War I began in 1914 and the firm stopped operations. When the war ended in 1918, licenses were withdrawn from the Nigerian Bitumen Corporation and given to the DRC Exploration Company and Whitehall Petroleum. However, these companies did not perform excellently, making them return their license in 1923. The discovery. In 1933, Shell, the RC Petroleum Development Company of Nigeria, a consortium of Shell and British Petroleum, formerly known as Anglo-Iranian, began exploratory work after it was issued a license which covered 920,000 km². The company began to drill in 1951, and the first test was a drill in Owerri. To the company's delight, in 1953, it discovered oil in non-commercial quantities at Akata near Eket in present-day Akwa Ibom State. The company was determined to discover oil in commercial quantity, hence the work continued tirelessly with over £6 million spent. At last, on the 15th of January 1956, oil was discovered in Oloibiri in Ogbia local government area of present-day Bayelsa State. Oloibiri is about 45 miles east of Port Harcourt in the Niger Delta. This was a source of joy to Nigeria because of how much it would enrich the nation. By 1960, other oil companies had got exploratory rights, meaning that Shell did not have the sole right for exploration anymore. Shell, however, kept performing excellently, that as of 1965, the company discovered the EA field in the shallow waters of the southeastern part of Warri. Nigeria joins OPEC. After the Nigerian Civil War in 1970, the prices of oil increased, bringing in a lot of money for the country. A year later, Nigeria joined the Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, for oil exporting nations that coordinates and unifies the petroleum policies of its member countries. Members of OPEC produce about 40% of the world's crude oil and possesses almost 82% of the world's total proven crude oil reserves. The 14 members of OPEC are Algeria, Angola, Congo, Ecuador, Equatorial Guinea, Gabon, Iran, Iraq, Kuwait, Libya, Nigeria, Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, and Venezuela. The establishment of NNPC. On the 1st of April 1977, the Nigerian National Petroleum Company, NNPC, was established as a state-owned and controlled company which offers exploration and production, gas development, refining, petrochemical distribution, engineering, refinery services, and commercial investments. Nigeria began to do excellently with oil production with 2 million barrels daily in the 70s, 4 million barrels daily in 2010, but in recent time, Nigeria produces only about 1.99 million barrels daily. Nigeria experienced some downtimes with oil exportation at some point and as a result stopped exporting crude oil to the United States in July 2014 when the US stopped buying from Nigeria. However, the country still exports oil to India, the United Kingdom, Germany, and China. Oil spills and water contamination. Oil spills are a common and dangerous occurrence in Nigeria. Record states that about 13 million barrels of oil have been spilled since oil drilling began in Nigeria. The common causes of oil spillage are corrosion of pipelines and tankers, which accounts for about 50% of all spills, sabotage or bunkering, which amounts for about 28% of oil spills, oil production operations, which amounts for 21%, and 1% is as a result of the inadequate or non-functional production equipment. Oil spills have a damaging impact on the ecosystem because it destroys large tracts of mangrove forests. About 10% of the Nigerian mangrove ecosystems have been eliminated by oil spillage. These spills also destroy crops and aquatic animals through contamination of groundwater and soils, and drinking water is contaminated. This is one of the major factors that activists from the Niger Delta region agitated for, and successive governments, including the Sons on the Soil, have always promised and failed the region. Did you know? The number of active oil rigs in Nigeria rose to 32 in 2018, from 13 in 2017 and 9 in 2006. Due to fall in global oil prices in 2014, Nigeria's rig count dropped from 46 to 29. Rig count shows the level of exploration, development, and production activities that occurred in the oil and gas sector. The suspension of attacks on the oil facilities in the Niger Delta triggered the rig count in 2018. The number of wells in Nigeria's oil industry dropped from 141 in 2014 to 116 in 2015. It further dropped to 76 in 2017, then increased to 81 in 2018. Nigeria has the second largest proven oil reserves in Africa, with an estimated 37.5 billion barrels of crude oil deposits at the end of 2017, representing 2.2% of global total. What have we missed out of this history? Let's know in the comment section. Will it be ridiculous to subscribe to our channel? If no, please like this video, share, and subscribe to our channel.